卖了卖了，我卖啦！
别紧张好吗，各位？我没有卖出我狗币或是比特币的部位，我卖出的是我的美股哦。艾伦哥哥大幅减码了我自己个人美股持仓的部位，原因很简单，因为我个人觉得呢，美国的通膨隐忧啊，真的是太严重了。我个人是认为未来的美国啊，一定会有升息的打算，只是什么时候会升息呢？我也不知道。那虽然我这个升息的预测呢，说出去以后可能要被啪啪啪打脸，因为美国联准会最近才说他们不会有任何升息的打算，然后美国现在也没有任何的通膨隐忧，但是我个人觉得他们都在放屁，所以你们也不需要去听他说什么了。我跟你们讲，在我回来美国的两个月，我所看到的通膨隐忧啊，其实是非常严重的。首先第一点，现在加州的房价可以说是用喷发式的往上暴涨啊。我们家在过去的四年里，每一年的涨幅啊，差不多就只有5%左右哦。但是我们家在过去的一年里已经涨了20%了，我没有在盖你们。所有的美国人现在都觉得房地产是最可靠、最有效率抗通膨的资产，所以一窝蜂的所有的热钱全部都集中到了房市里面去。那这也就导致于现在房市里面房源啊是少的可怜，因为所有人都想要买，但是没有人想要卖啊。所以这边面加州任何一个破烂的房子，只要一有房源一上市，跟你讲，绝对20-30个人抢着下，然后最后成交的价钱啊，都是在卖家的预期之上啊。那更不要说我们食衣住行上面的花费好了，油价在加州也是喷喷喷往上涨，食衣住行呢更不用说。我现在去超商随便想要买个3天的物资哦，3天而已，如果不花到$100，超市的店员啊是不会让我走出去的啊，他直接关门放狗啊。那刚刚超商那段是干话，在美国的各位千万不要被吓到，我怕你们太久没去超商，以后都不敢进去了。那以我刚刚的分析来说，我相信各位也听得出来，通膨的隐忧现在是绝对有的。那只要美联准啊一旦宣布升息的话，股票我个人是觉得势必会回调的。不要说股票好了，我个人觉得房地产可能也要回调一点，就像我们股神巴菲特前几天在我们股东发表会上面的言论一样，他当时说了，利息啊对于资产的估值就如同地心引力一般一样重要。这句话呢讲的白话一点，就是在说如果升息的话，所有资产的估值啊都将会大幅的缩水。那如果你还是听不懂的话，我讲的再白话一点，我们老巴的意思就是说，如果升息的话，股市会跌，房地产会跌，所有的资产都会全部下跌就是了。然后外加现在的美股跟美国的房市都是在历史高点，所以我个人用我长期打扑克的逻辑去分析的话，我个人觉得啊，要再继续往上喷发的话，可能能力有限，最多要继续涨的几率大概落在于20%吧，然后下跌的几率可能会在40%左右。那剩下的40%呢？各位不要忘记了，股票市场不是说只有涨跌而已，它可以很长时间在一个区间震荡，然后都不动啊。我觉得呢，这个剩下的40%呢，就是这个区间震荡的可能性啊。它可以震荡个1-2年都不动，这也是很正常的啊。我知道在过去的10年里，各位有在投资美股的朋友们，可以说是每一年都爽赚啊。然后几乎每一年股票永远都是直线往上涨，只要股票没有卖出，每一年都一直抱着，每个人的荷包啊都可以说是笑呵呵啊，塞满满的啊。但是各位千万别忘了，股票在很长的时间里面上下盘整不动不上不下也是非常有可能的。那我这边也再三强调，我只是卖出了我部分的股票，我并没有全部脱手，所以我还是持有一部分的股票的。然后我这边所说卖出的美股呢，也只是我个人的部位，我们达克报的跟单计划也还是继续在进行的。那我记得上一支达克报跟单实测3个月前，我们的投资金额差不多是在$117,900左右。那截至于今天呢，6月17号，我这边的投资部位是有118,541，也就是说这3个月我只赚了$600美金，并没有赚多少。然后前面几个月我的股票部位还一路跌到113,000，还112,000左右。那我觉得最近值得一提的一点是，达克报最近他们也把比特币列入到他们观察的资产里面了。他们觉得比特币在31,500这个价位已经算是不错的价位，可以开始建仓了。所以如果价钱达到31,500左右的时候呢，我个人也会在我这个达克报部位里面建仓。然后外加我个人的资产呢，我也决定我会在里面加购一些比特币哦。所以如果你有在听的话，我个人的观点应该是，我目前更看好比特币胜过于美股。但是以上也只是我个人的观点而已哦。 绝对不是投资建议，因为我也不是一个分析师什么的，我就只是一个韭菜，没错，我就只是一个韭菜。那说到比特币的话，最近最大的新闻就是在6月4号的时候，国际知名骇客组织匿名者发布了一支影片，去抨击我们现代钢铁侠在推特上面炒币的作为哦。
Greetings, citizens of the world. This is a message from Anonymous for Elon Musk.For the past several years, you have enjoyed one of the most favorable reputations of anyone in the billionaire class, because you have tapped into the desire that many of us have to live in a world with electric cars and space exploration. But recently, your carefully created public image is being exposed, and people are beginning to see you as nothing more than another narcissistic rich dude who is desperate for attention. It appears that your quest to save the world is more rooted in a superiority and savior complex than it is in actual concern for humanity.This has been obvious to your employees for a long time, who have faced intolerable conditions under your command for years. It is also obvious to the young children working in your overseas lithium mines, which are destroying the local environment as well. You have been open about your willingness to stage coups in order to install dictators in places where your toxic products are being mined. You have even prematurely crowned yourself Emperor of Mars, a place where you will be sending people to die.Your fanboys overlook these issues because they are focused on the potential good that your projects can bring to the world, but you are not the only show in town, and your competition is growing more intense with each passing day. There are plenty of other companies working on space exploration and electric vehicles, you are just the only CEO who has gained a cult following through shitposting and trolling the world on social media. In fact, many people are now learning that the vast majority of Tesla's income doesn't actually come from selling cars,It comes from government subsidies, selling carbon tax credits for your innovation with clean energy. This technically isn't your innovation though, because you aren't actually the founder of Tesla, you simply purchased the company from two people much more intelligent than you are, Martin Eberhard and Mark Tarpenning. Tesla has also made more money holding Bitcoin for a few months than they did in years of selling cars. It is also more than likely that this Bitcoin was purchased with money from these government subsidies.It is now widely believed that you have been forced to denounce your company's involvement with Bitcoin in order to keep that green government money flowing into Tesla's coffers. The energy use argument about proof-of-work mining is a very nuanced conversation that requires a fairly complex understanding of how power grids work, and how excess energy is wasted by power companies, and sought out by crypto miners. This is a conversation that you have been having for over a year and were intimately aware of.But as soon as your main source of income was threatened, you pretended to be clueless in an attempt to play both sides of the fence. Then, your move to create a Bitcoin miner council was rightly seen as an attempt to centralize the industry and take it under your control. Reading from the comments on your Twitter posts, it seems that the games you have played with the crypto markets have destroyed lives. Millions of retail investors were really counting on their crypto gains to improve their lives.This is something that you will never understand because you were born into the stolen wealth of a South African apartheid emerald mine and have no clue what struggle is like for most of the working people in the world. Of course, they took the risk upon themselves when they invested, and everyone knows to be prepared for volatility in crypto, but your tweets this week show a clear disregard for the average working person. As hard-working people have their dreams liquidated over your public temper tantrums, you continue to mock them with memes from one of your million-dollar mansions.You may think you are the smartest person in the room, but now you have met your match. We are anonymous. We are legion. Expect us.
那随后在6月14号的时候，我们的马斯克也在推特上面发表了推文，再三强调的特斯拉只卖出了 10% 的比特币哦，目的则是要去确认比特币现在在市场上的流通性。然后只要有超过 50% 的虚拟货币矿场是使用再生能源来挖矿的话，特斯拉就会回复再接受比特币的制度哦。那此话一出以后呢，6月14号的当天，比特币就直接飞天了，飞到40,000块一颗左右的价位。所以如果比特币继续往下回调，跌到31,500、32,000左右的话，我就会开始再陆陆续续购买我比特币的部位了。那如果你对免费美股分析平台达克报有兴趣的话，不妨可以参考一下我下面的连结，现在使用我的注册码 Alan 还可以打8折优惠哦。然后如果你对投资虚拟货币有兴趣的话，我也会把世界最大的交易所放在下面连结。那我们就过几天再见啦，拜拜。